What if I told you you can download 5 4K movies in just a second? Wow, really fast, right? So you're telling me that 5G all about super fast internet on mobile networks? No, actually, the least interesting thing about 5G is phones. So what's 5G? How it works? How it will change our world as we know it? Let's find out. But before we start, if we're just meeting, my name is Ahmed Hanafi, coming up. Understand what is 5G, let's go back and show you how the wireless networks evolved over the years. And it started in 1950 with push-to-talk system. It was walkie-talkie, single channel communication, half duplex. If you need to talk, just press the button, talk, then release it to receive. Then in 1960 evolved so both parties can communicate to each other simultaneously, full duplex. In 1970, the private companies started to develop their own systems. Then 1982, the first generation officially introduced. It was radio signal, analog radio signal. So the voice was not clear, the calls might drop sometimes, but still, you are able to call someone before you are able to call places, locations with the landline. So being able to call someone, it was revolutionary. Then in 1991, it became digital. The calls now is more stable and clear, and it brought to us short messages, SMS. That was delivering a kind of slow data, but it was okay for some business solutions. Till the 3G introduced in 1999 and brought to us mobile data, faster mobile data. So now you can check emails, you can browse internet from your mobile phone with speeds up to 3 Mbps. Now the mobile internet is faster than before. And now we're in 2010, where the 4G is here. Fourth generation, real fast internet, more reliable and stable video services, YouTube, Netflix, video calls, all other video services and streaming services. With real fast internet with speeds up to 1 gigabit per second, 10 times faster than 3G. This speed is more than enough for anyone, however the world won't implement new technologies now, like VR, virtual reality, AI, artificial intelligence, IoT, Internet of Things. And these technologies depend on something called latency, which is an average between 50 and 150 milliseconds for the 4G, which is not enough. But what's latency? Latency is the time it takes source to send data to a receiver. And it's measured by milliseconds. The lower is better. The lower is more real time. That's why the world was in desperate need for 5G. The latest wireless network generation, the fifth generation, which designed virtually to connect everyone and everything with objects, machines, devices, everything would be connected to each other with almost no latency. 1 millisecond, real-time connectivity with speeds up to 10 gigabit per second, at least 10 times faster than 4G. But how 5G is capable of providing such high speeds with almost real-time connectivity? That brings us to the question about how 5G actually works. Well, the previous wireless networks have operated on the same radio frequency bands of the electromagnetic spectrum. These radio waves became increasingly congested with cellular traffic. To compensate, cellular providers want to expand into the higher frequencies of the millimeter waves. The millimeter waves use frequencies from 30 to 300 gigahertz, which is 10 to 100 times higher than the radio waves used nowadays for 4G and Wi-Fi networks. The higher frequency of millimeter waves may create new lanes on the communication highway. But there is one problem here. The millimeter waves are easily absorbed by buildings and obstacles and require so many closely based stations to function properly. Fortunately, these stations are smaller and require less power than the traditional cell towers and can be put at top buildings or light poles everywhere. And this enabled another thing called MIMO, many in, more, many out, or multiple in, multiple out. so you can serve so many different users at the same time. But this required new infrastructure, very expensive, take years to be fully deployed with its full capacity. Now we've discussed what's 5G, how it works. Now it's time to discuss what's in it for me, what I will do with all these features, with all these numbers. What I will do, how it will change the world, how it dramatically will change everything around you. Let's see. Thanks to the real-time connectivity and almost zero latency, 5G considered the oxygen for autonomous cars, self-driving cars, and drones. Surely because of its speeds and ability to compute in real time. It will be able to connect to other buildings, vehicles, street lights, and will create better, smarter, safer vehicles that can avoid accidents and keep our streets safe. Of course, much of this relies on the concept of using the IoT, Internet of Things, to build smarter and more connected cities. On the other hand, imagine how many lives can be saved by performing surgeries from hundreds of miles away. Because it's so reliable, surgeons know that there will be no unexpected glitches or downtime during the procedures. This could revolutionize healthcare of people living in remote areas of the world. And surely the gaming community is celebrating the launch of 5G more than any other, because of its speed and real-time gaming and no glitches or lags. The online gaming and the e-gaming, it will be super fast and super reliable. In many ways, 5G is our way of catching up the technology we've created to allow it to act the way we designed it to, with endless possibilities. Eventually, don't forget to subscribe, like, or leave a comment. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.